Today, Daniel Kwasnitschka will teach you 5S.
Seiri, Seiton, Saiso, Saiketsu, Shitsuke. Is there anyone who can guess what we're doing today? Correct. We're learning Japanese. Well, not really the language, but a workplace organization methodology derived from the Japanese terms beginning with the letter S. It is used to create an effective and attractive workplace while supporting visual control, easing communication, and helping continuous improvement. Indirectly, it yields higher safety, reduced delivery times and process costs, better product quality, as well as improved worker satisfaction and productivity. So how does it work? Well, let's have a look at the first and the second S, Seiri and Seiton. They belong together. Usually, Seiri is translated to sort. You want to sort things at your workplace, deciding what is actually needed to get the job done and what is not. Seiton, on the other hand, can be translated to set an order or to straighten. Here, it is all about sequencing and visual labeling of locations. You want to make sure to reduce the non-value-adding activity of searching for items, tools, and documents. Talking about documents, where is the script of this video?
2 hours later.
Oh, there it is. Well, you see, this is important for any kind of workplace. Actually, the core meaning of Seiri Seiton, that is to keep only what you soon need close to you in orderly designated places, is the foundation of this 5S framework. So once you have understood the foundation of 5S, let's move on to the third and the fourth S, namely seisō and seiketsu. Seisō is often translated to sweep, shine, or scrub. We could also call it cleaning, which would probably be even more accurate, but it doesn't really begin with an S. So, you know, it's called the 5S, and you see. The goal here is to keep machine and equipment functional, visual, and well-maintained. On the other hand, seiketsu usually translates to standardize in the sense of maintaining a standard. So let me be clear. It is not about creating work standards, but more about sustaining the first 3S. It can be seen as some sort of an ideal status after sorting, setting an order, and cleaning up. So in some sense, you can say it is about creating and maintaining standards for Seiri, Seiton, and Seiso. Well, we're almost done with our Japanese excursion. The 5S framework is finally completed by adding the fifth S, Shitsuka. Shitsuka, which stands for discipline, educated, or following the rules, even though the most usual English translation would be sustain. However, it is important to note the sustain can be misleading translation, as Shitsuka is not about sustaining the first 4S per se. It is rather a fundamental culture building process that makes sure that people understand the purposes of the 4S and are motivated to act on them. Shitsuka should manifest itself in deeds and habits such as washing hands, especially important in these days, but also, you know, in respecting the work time, using proper clothes and safety equipment, or following standard operating procedures. Finally, I ask you, next time you go to any type of workplace, this can be your office desk, your kitchen, somewhere in industry, or the laundry room, who knows? And I want you to see if you can apply this framework. I promise you, this can be a lot of fun and also, you know, applicable to your daily life. I mean, as you already know, POM matters everywhere.